Hello again, and welcome back in the flight deck of this Boeing 787 Dreamliner from TUI for the return flight from Curaçao to Amsterdam. We've had a bit of a head start with our flight deck preparations, but we're not done yet, so come and have a look with us again where we finalize our preparations for the flight to Amsterdam. Okay.
We have a departure time at 2:30, so it gives us 18 minutes for departure.
Yep.
It's my turn today to fly towards Amsterdam. We have a flight time tonight of 8 hours and 19 minutes. Routing is pretty straightforward. It's basically almost following the Great Circle track. So yeah, let's start the briefing for this departure in Curaçao. We have checked the aircraft. It's ETOPS checked. No further items. NOTAMs. We know the ILS is not working today.
Yep.
So if we have to come back, we have making the RNF approach on runway 11. The weather, you happy with the weather?
Yeah, weather is fine.
Perfect. Fuel-wise,
we have a little extra, about 500 kilograms on this route.
Yeah, we took flight plan fuel, covers everything. So, we are standing today at position number 5. I expect a normal engine startup simultaneously. With a pushback, can you tell me the pushback of the taxi out route to runway 11?
Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. On to taxiway Alpha, parallel to the runway, to the beginning of runway 11.
Yep. Expecting the departure clearance during the taxi phase. But basically, in the FMC, I have programmed an easterly departure via Olito and Bonax. So, could you read the FMC departure, and then I'll check it on the plate.
Yeah, runway track is 113 degrees to Olito for 3 nautical miles, and then we'll turn to 106 track to Bonax for 63 nautical miles.
That checks. That's basically a straight line.
Yep.
MSA here, it's 2,300 feet all around, and we have a transition altitude of 2,500 feet. Non-normals for today, between 80 knots and V1, we stop for fire warning, engine failure, aircraft unsafe, unable to fly, or a predictive wind shear warning.
Yep.
After V1, we continue, and there is no emergency turn procedure here at Curaçao. So you are happy with a altitude of 3,000 feet for the level off?
Yeah, although that is inside the transition layer, so then we might as well press on to level 4-5 or level 5-0.
Okay, sure.
Because the transition altitude is 2,500 feet.
Yeah, sure. We'll take 4-5.
Okay.
Yeah? Right. Threats and errors today. It's pretty standard.
Yeah, other than the fact that
the usual stuff. We got birds,
yeah,
but it's nighttime, so they should be on the ground. ATC is well known. VFR traffic now is, of course, less.
Yeah.
So other than that, I don't see any other threats and errors. And if you don't have any questions, then we can continue.
I have no questions, no add-ons. I'm happy.
Roger.
All right. Then I'll do a quick PA to the passengers, and then we can request pushback and startup clearance.
Yes.
Dames en heren, allemaal een hele goede avond en ook vanuit de cockpit hartelijk welkom aan boord van deze Boeing 787 Dreamliner van TUI. Mijn naam is Bart van Haarlem, ik ben uw gezagvoerder op deze reis van Curaçao naar Amsterdam en ik word vanavond in de cockpit bijgestaan door mijn collega's eerste officieren Patrick Amelaan en Zeb Habraken. En Zeb gaat ons vanavond naar Amsterdam vliegen. We zijn bijna gereed voor vertrek. We vragen zo toestemming om de motoren te starten. En dan laten we ons terugduwen van deze parkeerplek. Daarna taxiën we uit naar de startbaan. We gaan opstijgen in oostelijke richting. Dat wordt gevolgd door een flauwe linkerbocht om onze route te onderscheppen. En als we op onze eerste vlieghoogte zijn aangekomen, dan kom ik zelf of een van mijn collega's nog even bij u terug. En dan leggen we uit hoe de route gaat naar Amsterdam. Vliegtijd vannacht bedraagt 8 uur en 19 minuten. Ik wens u allemaal een heel aangename reis. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and also from the flight deck a warm welcome aboard this Boeing 787 Dreamliner from TUI. My name is Bart van Haarlem, I'm your captain on this flight to Amsterdam and I'm joined in the flight deck tonight by two colleagues, first officers Patrick Ammerlaan and Zep Habrake. And Zep will be flying us to Amsterdam tonight. We're almost ready for departure, we'll be requesting permission to start the engine shortly and then we'll taxi out to the runway for an easterly departure followed by a slight left-hand turn to pick up our route of flight and as soon as we reach our first cruising altitude, I myself or otherwise one of my colleagues will come back to you and we'll explain the route to Amsterdam. Flight time tonight will be 8 hours and 19 minutes. I wish you all a very pleasant flight.
Auto ground, orange 362, stand number 5, request startup and the pushback.
Orange 362, push and start approved.
Push and start approved, orange 362.
Auto.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yes. Okay. And you have controls up.
I have control. Take off.
Runway 11, confirmed. Thrust is set.
Ninety knots.
Check.
B1.
Rotate. Positive rate.
Gear up.
Thrust rev, VNF speed.
Check. Select flaps up.
Standard set level 2-2.
The after takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. After takeoff checklist complete.
Checklist complete.
Outer tower orange 362 is passing level 60.
Orange 362, outer tower roger, airborne time was 30. Contact Curaçao Control 127.1, noting.
Contact Curaçao Control 127.1, orange 362. Curaçao Control, vanavond orange 362, climbing level 290 to Bonac.
Orange 362, roger, the contact passing 70, continue climb flight level 410.
Continue climb flight level 410, orange 362.
Correct. Level 410 is set.
410 is checked. We are requesting new winds for the FMCs. To do that, I've taken out the old winds. There is a tailwind on this route, so now
since the FMC has no wind information for the moment, she thinks we won't have enough fuel for the trip to Amsterdam, but that will be solved once the new winds are entered in the FMC. We are in the climb to level 410, which is our first and final cruise level today. We're almost there, and we have a tailwind of 59 knots at the moment. Tailwind is picking up as we climb, and that does something to the climb performance of this aircraft. She's quite sensitive to changes in wind, so if the headwind picks up or the tailwind decreases, you'll see her climb performance improve. But as the tailwind picks up, you'll notice that the climb performance will decrease, because as the tailwind increases or headwind decreases, then the speed changes will have an immediate effect on the climb performance of this aircraft.